Hi, this is A Minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this week I want to talk about why we use Admob for all of our ads. Okay, so as an app developer who has a lot of apps that are free on the market, one of the things I'm always thinking about is how do I make money from them? So the way we make money, the way most app developers make money is through advertisements within the app. And in order to put ads within the app, there's different ad networks. You could go out and find your own advertisers and your own sponsors, but that would take such a long time, and they probably wouldn't want to pay you, specifically for your app until it's gained a user base anyway. So we use Admob, and Admob is one of the big ad providers out there. There are lots. We've tried lots of them. We've tried Chartboost, Revmob, Ad Colony, Flurry, Tapjoy, all of them. And what I found was, and the reason why I always keep coming back to Admob is because Admob seems to grow consistently over time, and it seems to be better supported on Android and outside the United States. A lot of app developers I talk to, they say, "Oh, you shouldn't be. You get higher click-through rates on Flurry, or you get higher, impressions and everything on this." But they seem to have apps that are more focused on, say, iPhone, especially. In fact, most app developers who give you advice are very focused on iPhone, and also within the States. So what I was finding that ad impressions within in Brazil on Android were horrible, and that's like one of the biggest user bases that we have. So that's one of the reasons why I move away from Admob, thinking all the promises of I'll come to our network. In fact, if you get enough downloads, that's one of the biggest bits of spam you get, or people calling you saying, "Hey Eric, I want to know if you've ever considered app monetization," as if it was like a new thing. Like I don't think about app monetization. So every time their promises that they have a higher click-through rate or whatever, they move over to them, but they don't have the size that Admob does. So as much as it's frowned upon to be an app developer that uses Admob, I stick with Admob. All the ads you see in our apps are Admob. And there's also one more reason is because I had an app pulled or suspended about a year ago, and the reason they said was because I had malware in it. Right. And I thought, well, hang on a second. There's no malware in this. Yeah, I know the code backwards and forwards. There's definitely no malware. There's just these ad network providers. And I think what it was is one of the ones that was a little bit more, they promise a high click rate, but they weren't quite legit. So I'm putting their code within my app. There's one thing with Admob, since it's owned by Google, I don't have to worry about them shutting something down because somebody sneaks something in. So anyway, for what it's worth, you could go with whatever ad network you like. Please tell me if you find it one that works better, especially if it works better outside the United States, in foreign languages and on Android. Because for me, it's been Admob all the way. Every time I've left, I've been like regretting it and had to come back to use Admob. So that's it for this week. Now, if you're watching this on the iTunes podcast, please leave a review. I'd love to know what you think. And if you're watching this on YouTube, leave a comment or Facebook or LinkedIn. Please leave a comment. And I want to tell you about a new game we released this week. It's called Mandarin Flash Quiz. It's a very high-speed Learn Mandarin game. If you're a Mandarin learner like myself, please go down and download it. It's on Google Play now. It'll be on iTunes within the next few weeks. Okay, that's it. I'll talk to you next week.